After the first wave of enthusiasm about the single-agent targeted drugs like ibrutinib and venetoclax, the big question becomes now, how can you predict resistance? We know that patients will have a relapse after some years, and with some genetic backgrounds it becomes earlier. But the question is, how can you predict resistance? And one of the things that we have developed is, what we know is one of the escape mechanisms is an altered expression of anti-apoptotic molecules, specifically BCL-XL and MCL1, which are anti-apoptotic molecules. Those molecules are increased, overexpressed in the lymph nodes, but actually are downregulated in the blood. And by taking a gating strategy that we took from Nick Chiarazzi from New York, actually in the blood we can gate out the cells that just came from the lymph nodes and cells that were for a long time in the blood and actually go back to the lymph nodes. And if you compare in those two subsets expression levels of BCL-XL and MCL1, what we see if you give them ibrutinib, that the difference between this early immigrants of the lymph nodes and the late immigrants, that the difference between BCL-XL and MCL1 is very big in the beginning but falls completely away during ibrutinib. But when a patient gets resistance, then you see that it opens up again, and then you get, I think that could be a very good marker for resistance of therapy.